What's your name, bro? Bruce, what's your name? Raheem. All right, y'all from this area, right?
Yeah.
So y'all understanding what we're bringing to this area as far as knowledge of the Bible, right? So if I ask you your nationality, what are you gonna say it is now? What is your race?
I'm African-American.
African-American, so you still saying that? What you gonna say, Raheem? You're gonna say Christian. So we have two continents and a religion. But what we're trying to show our people is who they are according to the Bible and why it's important to know that.
Right.
You understand that? Because, let's get that. Deuteronomy 28, 15. Go ahead.
Deuteronomy chapter 28 and verse 15.
This is the importance of you actually knowing what your name is. Read.
But it shall come to pass, if thou wilt not hearken unto the voice of the Lord thy God.
So, for us going into slavery and being in these conditions here in America, what happened was we broke God's laws. That's the reason why we went into slavery on slave ships.
Right.
That's the reason why we became slave men and slave women to our enemies.
Right.
That is why we still serve our enemies till this day. Because we made a decision as God's chosen people not to follow our God-given laws.
Right.
Read on.
To observe, to do all his commandments.
So it's not something that we just talk about. So when I ask you your nationality, that's something we bring up in speech, right? But now we don't even speak the right thing.
Right.
So we got to come back to what the Bible is showing us is the cause and effect of our disobedience. You understand that, right? You with me? Read.
And in statutes, which I command thee this day, that all these curses shall come upon thee and overtake thee.
Curses are bad things, right, Raheem? Somebody curse you out, that's a bad thing. Yeah. You're going to probably look at it a certain way, right?
Words don't hurt you.
Words don't hurt you, but if I call you a black man, that's not who you are, is it? According to God, that's not who you are. If I call you an African-American, actually what I'm doing is attributing or giving all your God-given talent, your God-given blessings to white people.
Right.
When I call you an African-American, Leo Scipio Africanus is a black man. I mean, a white man who conquered black people.
Yeah.
You understand that? Amerigo Vespucci is the white man they gave America over to. They said, oh, he was the one who discovered America. You understand that? But guess what? Our people were over here first.
Right.
You understand that? So you're not African American. You're not just a regular Christian. They'll call you a black Christian. You understand that? But this is how we got these different names.
Right.
Curses came upon us. Read verse 37.
Verse 37?
Because this is what took place after we got off the slave ships. Read.
And thou shalt become an astonishment and a proverb.
An astonishment. What would you say an astonishment is, Raheem? I know you went to Wilson, didn't you?
Nope.
What school you went to?
West Florence.
Oh, that's the better side of town, right? As they say.
Yep.
But what is an astonishment?
I really don't know.
You don't really know? What do you say an astonishment is?
Unbelievable.
Something that blows your mind, that surprises you. Wilson, football. Great athletes that came through there, right? Friday night, they are an astonishment to all the people that's out there. That boy can run fast. He can jump high. You saw how far he threw that ball? We are an astonishment to our good, but to our bad. You see how strung out Lil Ray Ray is now?
Jeez.
Lil Ray Ray used to be the smartest person in school. Now he's strung out on drugs. You understand that? So astonishment can be a good thing, but God said for disobedience, bad things are going to happen.
Right.
You understand that? We also are an astonishment because we sag our pants around the neighborhood.
Right.
We are changing our kind. You got men wanting to be women, women wanting to be men.
Right.
The household out of order. That is an astonishment. Who the sheriff? Kenny Boone. That's an astonishment to him. That's why he lock us up all the time.
Right.
You understand that? That's how you look at us now, right?
Now.
Oh, look at him now, right? Oh, praise. Read.
And thou shalt become an astonishment.
An astonishment, read.
A proverb.
A proverb, a wise saying. That's what a proverb is, a wise saying. You want to hide anything from a black man, where do you put it? Where do you put it? In a book. What book are they talking about? The Bible.
That's right.
Because for a long time we've been saying, oh, the Bible is a white man's book.
Jeez.
The Bible ain't got nothing to do with black people. But then you ask the black man, well, what book does have anything to do with us? I don't know, man. I don't gotta have no book to tell me who I am. Well, you call yourself African American, so obviously you do need something.
Right.
This is the book. This book has our truth.
Right.
But now we live by that proverb.
Right.
They also say this. Finish this off, Raheem. Which one was it? You hide anything from a black man, put it in a book. know your history or what? Be doomed to repeat it. So guess what? Because we don't know the truth of this Bible, we still live in slavery.
Right.
You understand that? Read the next part.
And a byword.
And a byword. Your byword is African-American. Your byword is a black Christian. Is that your God-given name?
Jeez.
No. So let's find out what your God-given name is.
Read up.
Let's look on this sign. On this side of the sign is what God called you from your beginning.
Right.
On this side of the sign, this is what your slave master calls you. Read and now knows you as and wants you to call yourself that. Till this day. So which one are you? Find out what God calls you from the beginning.
Read
that up. I want Romans 12. Which one?
Judah.
You said Judah. What'd you say? And guess what? So these brothers say they from the mighty tribe of Judah.
Right.
Now guess what the importance of Judah is? Let's get there. Read Hebrews. Because you got to realize it's not just one person. It's a family, right? All of this is a family. But guess who comes out of the tribe of Judah? Right? Read.
Hebrews chapter 7 and verse 14.
Uh-huh.
Get out.
For it is evident.
For it is evident. So there's proof about what this Bible is going to show us. There's proof showing us the slave trade is real. But guess what? There's proof of also who comes out of the tribe of Judah, which makes that tribe so special.
Right.
For the family of Israel. Read.
For it is evident that our Lord sprang out of Judah.
Our That's Lord right. Jesus Christ, the black Messiah, sprang out of the tribe of Judah.
Right,
so
right.
My brothers right here, my sisters right here, the blood that runs through your veins is the same blood that runs through Jesus Christ's veins.
That's
the
right.
Messiah, the one who laid down his life for you.
Right.
For you to come out of your iniquity. For you to stop hating yourselves.
Right.
Stop prostituting yourselves on the street corners.
Right.
Whether it be through selling drugs or putting your body out there for people to see it. Never cherish it. We got to change the minds of our people. Get that in Romans 12.
Jeez.
Because that's what comes with knowing your God-given name.
Right.
Because we just saw our sisters, they go to this beauty salon, right? But who said that they needed to go buy their beauty?
Bring it out.
That's what this American Jeez. Society tells an African-American black woman.
Right.
That's what this society teaches our people. It doesn't teach us to love ourselves. Do you want to know why? Because in the back of the black woman's mind, this is the image of beauty. This is the Messiah. This is Christ. So you know what? My hair doesn't come out naturally stringy and looking like dog goat hair.
Jeez.
So I gotta go buy dog goat hair and not really cherish the beauty that God gave me from the beginning.
That's right.
That is the problem that we have to come back and search for solutions for in the Bible.
Right.
This is not a white man's book.
Right.
It's always been for the so-called blacks, Hispanics, and Native Americans.
That's right.
But watch what the message is. Read.
Romans chapter 12 and verse 2.
Uh-huh.
Yeah. And be not conformed to this world.
Start at verse 1. Start at verse 1.
Verse 1. I beseech you therefore.
So Paul is coming to the Israelites and giving them a message. He's beseeching them. Asking them to give ear to the word of God. Read.
Brethren, by the mercies of God.
Because God could have put us to death a long time ago for us being in the midst of sin and iniquity.
Right.
But because you have the opportunity to hear God's word today, the message is coming out for what you should do moving forward. Read.
That ye present your body.
Present your what?
Your body.
So you got to do something with your body, not present your mouth, not present your fairy tale words. You got to present your body a certain way. So the way that an Israelite man and woman dresses is a part of how God ordered us to be.
Right.
We know that we'll always say, you know what? We come from a lineage of kings and queens. Well, guess what? Bruce, I want you to ask them next time, well, why don't we act like it?
Right. Yeah.
If we know that we come from a lineage of royalty, why don't we look like it here in North Florence?
Hey.
Why don't we look like it when we go to school at Wilson High School or West Florence or South Florence?
Right.
Why don't we look like it?
Yeah.
We look like what they want us to look like because they put it on TV and we say, you know what? That's the image of greatness.
Right.
That's what he likes. That's what we're going to do. But guess what that makes us, Bruce?
Bring it out.
Modern day slaves.
Right.
They tell us what they want. They put it on TV and we do it.
Right.
Same way the slave master came outside, cracked the whip, whack. Hey, y'all niggas go over here and pluck everything up from that side of the field. Yes, I'm awesome. Right. That's what we do. Media is the modern day slave master.
Right.
Because it teaches us how to disobey God.
Right.
Our real master. Read on.
that ye present your bodies.
So we got to present our bodies and what we put in our body, how we dress our body, how we carry ourselves. Read.
A living sacrifice.
A living sacrifice. Because what are you sacrificing, Raheem? You're sacrificing that sin.
Right.
I notice every time a sister walk by, she got on the tights, which is out of order in God. You looking, right?
Bring it out.
Now, why is it is looking at a sister wrong?
No, but you a man.
At the end of the day, you a man. But what kind of man should you be from the tribe of Judah? As an Israelite man, what kind of man should you be? Give me Matthew 5. Because matter of fact, let's finish that off and then go to Matthew 5. Because it said it's going to go into conforming to this world or not conforming to this world. This world says, look at everything moving, right? Because guess what? They're making our sisters out to be whores.
Right.
If you're a king and your sister is a whore, guess what? You're a ruler over whores. That's not royalty. That's not royalty.
Right.
We as men have to establish the righteousness in our community.
Right.
Because if we're ruling over whores and drug dealers, we ain't that royal.
Bring it out.
We got to establish righteousness by doing what? Teaching the Bible.
That is right.
That you present your bodies a living sacrifice.
So that's a part of our living sacrifice. Putting away our sin personally and being the kings that God ordained to rule in success. Read.
Right.
Holy, acceptable unto God.
Acceptable unto God. Looking at your sister for lust is not acceptable to God.
Right.
You understand that? Read.
Which is your reasonable service.
Which is your reasonable service, meaning the only reason why you exist.
Jeez.
So when we live in sin, God say, I can't use you. Then we wonder why our people getting shot down in the streets.
Right.
We wonder why we living at the bottom of society, because you were created to be a king, a priest, a ruler, but you acting like any old nigga. That byword that they gave you in slavery.
Right.
You're still acting like a slave, not as what God ordained you to be.
Right.
That's the difference. Read on.
Verse 2. And be not conformed to this world.
Be not conformed to this world. This world says that our sisters must go to a beauty supply store. This world makes it okay for our sisters to walk around in tights and a bikini top.
Right.
Why? She's a princess.
Yeah.
When the last time, anybody, tell me, when the last time you seen a real princess walking around in tights and a bikini top? Don't they usually have on dresses and royal gowns and beautiful apparel? They come in the limo. They got a security escort, this, that, and the third. Our women out here all by themselves. Why? Because men ain't setting up the fortress of righteousness around them.
Right?
We ain't teaching that to our people.
Right.
So we got to get in order. But the Bible said, read that from again from the top. Verse 2.
Verse 2.
How you doing, sister?
And be not conformed to this world.
So this is what the Bible is saying to our people, the so-called blacks, Hispanics, and Native Americans. God calls us the Israelites.
Right.
That's the first way that we need to not conform to this world.
Right.
We call ourselves African American, Hispanic, Puerto Rican, Native American.
Right.
God says you are Israel.
That's right.
You understand that? So that's how we have to change our minds, knowing who you are first. Read on.
But be ye transformed by the renewing of your mind.
So your mind should be renewed that you now know that you are a child of Israel.
Right.
And that there's a culture that comes along with being Israel.
Right.
There's a way that you must dress, a way that you must eat, a certain ceremonies and feast days that you must attend.
Right.
Because God has already written it in the book for you to do. Read on.
That ye may prove what is that good.
Oh, so we think that on our deathbed we can go ask God and say, God, please forgive me for all my sins. God said you gotta prove yourself.
Right. Jeez.
You gotta prove yourself. On these streets out here, you know, when they get a young buck to go out and start finally selling drugs, hey, you ready to go put in this work? That's what they say. You ready to go put in this work, young man? Young buck, you ready to go put in this work? God said we got to put in the work too. We got to prove ourselves.
Right.
So are you ready to prove yourself? The scripture was brought out earlier. God asked the question, who's going to rise up? Who's going to do his work? Who's going to do his will? Read on.
And acceptable.
Uh-huh.
And perfect will of God.
So the will of God is to do his laws.
Right.
Now earlier we brought up you looking at sisters, right? Is there, you said that we men at the end of the day. But let's see what the black Messiah lived and died for us to fix. Read. Start in the part that goes 27. Read.
Matthew chapter 5, verse 27.
Uh-huh. Yeah.
ye have heard that it was said by them of old time, thou shalt not commit adultery.
Thou shalt not commit adultery. Two people having sex, but it's out of order, right? Committing adultery. Because what is in order when a man and wife get together? How do they know that their relationship is in order with God?
Right.
What do? They go and get what?
Married.
Marriage is honorable to God.
Right.
But adultery is when you do things outside of marriage.
Right.
Now, read on.
Verse 28. But I say unto you.
But we say unto you.
That whosoever looketh on a woman.
Uh-oh, it does what?
But whosoever looketh on a woman.
Man, they ain't even smashed yet, bro.
That whosoever looketh. On a woman.
Read.
To lust after her.
To do what?
Lust after her.
Because you can't tell me that in your mind, you ain't, man, if I had a chance to hit that, boy, I'd tear that ass up.
Right.
Right?
You're right.
You done looked at it, and now you're lusting after it.
Thank
you understand
God.
That? Thank it's your mind. The Bible says, be not, renew your mind. That's what the Bible says. But guess what? As a black Christian, your mind was conformed to this world.
Right.
Saying that it's okay, I'm a man at the end of the day. But as an Israelite man from the tribe of Judah, you got to realize that I can't do that no more.
Right.
Get that in Job. Get that in Job. Job. To lust after, you have committed adultery already in your heart, which is your mind, which has to change now that you know who you are. You see how the Bible is transforming us day by day through its instructions? Let's get this. Let's see what one of our forefathers said about how we look at our sisters. Read.
Job chapter 31, verse 1. I made a covenant with my eyes.
So what's a covenant, Bruce? What's a covenant?
A promise.
A promise. It said he had to make a promise with his eyes. Why? Read.
Why then should I think upon a maid?
Why then should I think upon a maid? Because that's what you say in your mind after you done seen all her precious things out in her. You see the camel toe, you see her behind in the back, see her breast poking out.
Right.
Now you think to yourself, man, if I had a chance to do that. Now you're thinking upon that maid.
Right.
Get out.
You understand? But the Bible is here to correct Israelite men, not just black Christians. You understand that? Because black Christians have had this Bible for a long time and ain't changed nothing.
Right.
You got pastors around this area right now sleeping with every woman on the front three rows.
Right.
Get out.
But they reading this Bible. So guess what? They ain't really reading it. They using it for their gain.
Right.
Get out.
They're using it for their gain. Not to edify the people, not to bring them out of their situations, not to bring them out of the confusion of who they are, not to even teach them that this is the man that is the devil that the Bible speaks of.
Right.
That person is not in the Bible. You understand that? Go to Joel 3. Because when we look at our sisters with lust, guess what we're doing our sisters in our nation? Because we're supposed to be the leaders, right? We're only keeping them in the same cycle that we've been put in from the beginning of slavery.
Joel chapter 3 and verse 3.
Read.
And they have cast lots for my people.
So when we were sold to the Grecians, they cast lots for our people. Nigga, sold to Master Johnson for $45 in Johnsonville, South Carolina, right? That's casting lots. Did that not happen to our people? But what were we sold for? Read on.
And I've given a boy for an harlot.
A boy for a harlot. So when we are out here in these streets, a whoremonger boy is just like what they bought him for. Because on the slave plantation, what did they do with the young men? Do you know?
Get out!
What did they do with the young men on plantations?
Teach!
Huh? If they was strong against the system. But what about the ones that just did what Master said? What you got, Raheem?
Kept them in the house.
Say what now?
Kept them in the house.
Kept them in the house? Nah, most of us were outside.
Right.
But what were we outside doing? We're outside sleeping woman to woman. Because the strongest buck on the plantation, he was the one having sex with all the women because they wanted to have strong children to go out in the field and perpetuate their slavery, make them more money, keep the plantation numbers up high.
Right.
You understand that? So, but what were our sisters used for? Because we still doing that today. When we look at our sisters for lust, we just trying to go sleep with that sister. And you know what? When she get the baby bump, that's when we peace out.
Right.
We want to leave. We don't want to take care of our household.
Bring it up.
Is that not what we see in our communities?
Bring
Is
it
that
up.
Not why our communities are destroyed? And why our young men and young women are out here looking for love in all the wrong places, going to gangs, looking to the OG.
Right.
Hey, OG, I ain't got no daddy figure. Well, I got you, young man. I'll set you up. Is that not the case? That's what we see. But what were our women used for? Read.
And sold a girl for wine.
And sold a girl for wine. So nowadays, all women are spectacles for fun. That's all. I saw it. Our women are spectacles for fun. That's why we see our sisters on TV showing their behinds, half they naked, or all the way naked. Jeez. You understand? And it's not the other nation. You don't see Arab women on TV, white women on TV. You always see our people, the right. So-called blacks, Hispanics, and Native Americans.
Right.
But what God calls us to do is repent and reform our minds.
We used to scream black power while Heron was pushed. But at the end of the day, nothing's in vain. IUIC has been given a vision. The tents of Judah has risen. Many has attempted the mission, minor murmuring, omitting, and missing the mark. Just reading that he had the flame of fire in his eyes gave us the spark. We on Paul's mission. We out on the road, purple and gold. From Mexico, Cuba, Haiti, Ghana, Sierra Leone. 144,000 boots banging, concrete crackling. These are how men repented at heart. The scriptures is proof. IUIC, we deliver the truth.